Hi, welcome to the RV Corral website. My name's Jim Beckler. Got a really nice travel trailer to show you today. This is a 2020, brand new. It's a relatively new floor plan too by Keystone. This is a Keystone Cougar. It's called the 32RD, two slide outs. Great bunkhouse model if you're looking for something that will be able to accommodate a large family. This is ideal. Or even if you just want the extra room, you don't have a big family but you want a good spacious trailer when you're out in it, this would be a good layout. Lots of really cool things to talk about on this trailer. You know, for starters, it's got the electric tongue jack on the front, which really makes it nice, much easier loading and unloading. Just push the button, you don't have to do a lot of cranking. You're going to have two 7-gallon propane tanks up front. We actually, when we do the pre-delivery inspection, we set this trailer up for you. We'll fill your propane tanks up. You're going to have two brand new batteries with battery boxes up front here also. So notice the nice front cap. This is a molded front cap, kind of one piece from here back. And then you've got the rock guard on the front here too to kind of protect the front of your trailer from things flying up and maybe doing some damage to the fiberglass. I like what they've utilized here with these magnets. It just makes it so much easier to open this up and keep it out of the way so you don't have to hold it up while you're trying to access stuff. Big pass-through storage area. Big door on both sides so you can get a lot of stuff in here easily. Notice how nicely it's finished out. Even the storage compartment's finished out nice. The Cougar's a really nice, kind of a higher-end travel trailer. This is definitely not entry level. You've got welded frame, aluminum frame construction, so your sidewalls, floors, pretty much everything. I think they use some wood still in the roof trusses to help reinforce rafters up there because it is a walk-on roof. So, but for the most part, and there's nothing wrong with that, that's just a good thing to have so you've got more stability. But this keeps the weight down overall, so it's not a super heavy trailer, even though it's a pretty good size unit. Notice that if you look at the welds, you can see that they're full welds. It's not just spot welded, you know, where there's some manufacturers will, you'll see a couple of beads on there, maybe it's not uniform. These are really nice uniform welds. To me, that says a lot about the quality of the unit. Been selling the Cougars now for about 15 years, so I'm pretty familiar with the product line, actually probably a little bit longer than that, but had very few complaints and overall really happy customers. This one's got it's already wired for portable solar panels, so if I wanted to utilize that feature, I just get myself the panels itself. They come in a, you know, you can just kind of open them up, set them out here, plug them in, and if you're dry camping a lot, help keep your batteries trickle charged. This one does have electric auto level system on it also. We'll maybe take a look at the other side once we get around the outside of the trailer. Notice the nice big awning covers both the doors. You do have two doors. This is your main entrance right here, and then that one goes into the bathroom area. We'll see once we get inside the trailer, it'll be a little easier to see that. But I like the fact it's got an LED light strip in there too. This lend a hand is a great feature too. Makes it much easier getting in and out. I do have some access to power there, so if I want to watch TV, I can. Black tank flush. It allows me to put pressured water. I can hook up a hose with pressured water to help keep my black tank cleaned out, spray out the inside of that. Outside shower, hot and cold water on that too. So maybe the kids are been out playing, they're all muddy. You can spray them down or maybe you've been in the sand. Here's a nice feature too. You got a really nice outside kitchen area with a pull out grill, so you got a grill steak, throw some steaks on there, some burgers or whatever the case may be. You got a power to propane hookup right there, so I can run it right into my quick connect right there. Just plug that in. I had all the propane I need. It's going to run off my main propane tank, so I don't have to have separate source of propane. Even has an outside sink here, hot and cold water. Got some storage up here where you can put some snacks or incidentals or whatever the case may be, even a little shelf up here in a little area here that you could use for working. Got even a 110 outlet and a refrigerator as well. See if we can take a look inside of this one. There we go. Pretty good size refrigerator. Big enough to keep some of your favorite beverages in there anyway. Even has a light in here. So we kind of walk around towards the back. We can see it does have a ladder to get up on top. Like I mentioned, it's a walk-on roof. So it's also tapered, as you can kind of see, helps keep things from pooling up on your roof. Even has a nice rain gutters. Notice up on the corners there, you got the gutters that extend out quite a ways. That way the water, when it runs off, it's not just going right down the side of your trailer, build up a little line of dirt where you can see where that water's been coming down this way. It's not going to be running right down the side of your trailer. Hook up back here for the TV connections. Here's my power source. It does have 50 amp power, as a matter of fact, so you got more power coming into your trailer than you would. A lot of trailers are only 30 amp, so this is 50, with the advantage being the more power you have going in, the more you have distributed. So it's, you got less problems with over utilizing maybe some circuits where you might have a problem with blowing a breaker or popping a fuse if you're using too many things on that one circuit. Having more power just makes you able to distribute that a little bit better. Fresh water connections right here. I mentioned something about the auto level. So here's that, where that panel is right here. So once I get to where I want my trailer, you pull it in, I disconnect, get my front jack down, that electric front jack, get that down, and then I'll just hit auto level and it'll level itself out. So it's going to utilize 4-point leveling on all the four corners, plus it utilizes the electric tongue jack. That's part of that whole process, so it'll just do the work for you, so you're not running all over the trying to find blocks to get this thing leveled out. It does all the work for you. Really nice feature. Like I mentioned, really nice higher quality trailer. If you're looking for something that's a cut above, definitely a good product line for that. They're well insulated. They're built in Oregon as well, which we like that. They're made in Pendleton. Some of these Cougars are, not all of them, but a lot of them are. And so just the fact that Keystone is a great manufacturer, and that's all they do is towables. I think that's a huge benefit to you and us as a dealership. We carry mostly Keystone products in our towable inventory. So we have four different Keystone lines. We like the value that they offer for, you know, the bang for the buck. Plus they're put together well. And like I said before, this is more of a higher end trailer. This is an entry level. So that if that's kind of what your thoughts are, you're ready to move up, and this could be a good opportunity. Probably going to miss some things, so feel free to give me a call at 541-510-1017. But let's take a look inside. Let's talk about what we got in here. When you first come in, I've got my in-command center right next to the door. So I don't have batteries in it right now, so I don't have power, so I can't really show you, demonstrate this. But once I turn it on, and it does have a code that you can program, so you could put your own private 4-digit code. It's not a real, you know, doesn't take rocket science to get into it. And then you have your main screen, your home screen. It's going to light up, and you'll see access to heating, air conditioning, lighting. I can move my slides out. I can kick my awning out. So I've got lots of different ways that I can access to controls inside of my trailer, all in one spot. This also has an app that you can download to your phone, so I could use my smartphone to do everything that this in-command system has. And I don't know, I didn't point it out when we were in the front compartment there, the storage compartment, but there's an in-command box right there. So that's the brains of the outfit, basically. I could access that too if I needed to, for whatever reason, to get to controls on this system. So lots of different ways you can do it, but it's just really convenient. You could be sitting out here in the patio enjoying the day, and you decide you want to turn the air conditioner on in here, didn't want to get up, you just grab your phone if it's right there handy and turn it on. It also has heated holding tanks. You'll like having that. You know, maybe you don't go out when the weather's not great, but there's times where you might get caught overnight where you get a drop in temperature, especially if you're at higher elevations. This will allow you to put direct heat to your holding tanks. It'll keep those things from getting too cold. Maybe you're fresh, your gray in your black tank. No problems that way with things freezing up on you. What's nice about this too is actually, you know, this is a 0 degree tested. It's enclosed underbelly. You have insulation under your tanks too. So what's really nice about this too is when I'm traveling, I can utilize these tank heaters if I'm in cold weather to put direct heat to my tanks, even when my furnace isn't on. So the fact that it is enclosed underbelly, heated when that furnace is on, you got radiant heat down there. They actually 0 degree test these coaches, so they're insulated well, and utilizing all that those features, you know, you should be able to be out in some cold weather and not have to worry about things freezing up on you, having tons of problems. Nice pull out drawers. And then let's swing maybe in here real quick since we're right here. So I've got a king size bed, walk around bed with some storage underneath. And then of course the front part of that is where we saw from the outside the storage. I like the fact there's nightstands on both sides also, so you got a pretty good size nightstand with power on both sides. So you got a USB ports plus 110 outlet, light back here, got some additional storage in here. Up on top you've got some storage too. Plus it is wired for a second air conditioner if you decided you want another air conditioner, but it's got a good AC unit in it. It's all ducted, so for the most part one air conditioner is going to do the job for you unless you're camping in the desert a lot where you get some extreme heat. Entertainment center is all ready to go right here. Got your flat screen TV. This is your house entertainment center. It's designed to play your DVDs, CDs, even has a USB port too, so you can have either stream some of your own stuff or plug in your phone, maybe run some, do a little photo op or whatever the case may be, photo show. There's a 110 outlet down there too. First time I noticed that. Kind of nice. Give you lots of power. That's one of the things you'll find in a more of a residential style trailer is they're going to have more, it's going to be better insulated for one thing. It's going to have better holding tanks, which this does have, and you're going to have a lot of power and a lot of lights. So a lot of places to plug in and a lot of lights. Notice all the lights in the slide out. It's got a big slide out that houses your sofa and your dinette. Now both of these will sleep as well, so you got the king bed up front. This is a what they call this, a sofa sleeper. So it's pulls out, makes into a like a queen size bed, and then this will make into a bed here also. I can just drop the table down and fill that cushions in, and I've got another sleeper right there. And look at all the drawer of the space down here. You got tons of storage in this. Pulls out. Even has a little dimmer on the lights in here. Kitchen has a refrigerator, freezer up on top, separate from the refrigerator. It's 8 cubic feet, so you got pretty good capacity there. Microwave plus a stove top. I like the fact it's got the cover here, so I can use that for workspace if I want to, or a backsplash in this case. 3 burners stove, good size oven. That's a 22 inch, that's the larger of the oven sizes. They usually have like a 17 inch, and some of the entry level stuff maybe a little smaller one. This is a little bit bigger unit, a little higher quality with the stainless steel front on it. And then your sinks, speaking of stainless steel, these are both stainless steel also. Nice two big sinks in there with sink covers. and has a little sprayer also. Got the storage up in here. More storage down here also under the sink. And then I've got drawers. Maybe that might be where you want to keep your silverware or whatever the case may be. But a nice little layout here. There's your, again, your, I said the air conditioning is all ducted, so you got a, this one actually has a quick connect, quick cool feature. So when I'm closing that off, when that air conditioner's on, it's pushing more air throughout the ductwork. So I'm going to have more air going to the back to the trailer or towards the front. If I want to cool this area down here as quickly as possible, I'll just open that up. It's going to push more air right in here so I can cool this area a little quicker. So here's, we're getting to the part of the trailer that's really set up for the family. As we get towards the back here, you can see, well, I've got a nice, good-sized pantry. Speaking of family, you're going to take a few more items with you. When you got quite a few people going with you, you can take a little more food. How cool is that, having a door to get into the bathroom area? So the kids are out playing. They want to use the bathroom. They don't have to run through the trailer and get in your way, or when you're trying to prepare a meal or just relax, they can just come in and go. And even maybe if they're all muddy, they don't have to track everything through your trailer. And you do have some additional closet space here. Great place for storage for towels or miscellaneous. Porcelain toilet bowl, and you know, a nice little cabinet in here for miscellaneous. Has a skylight and a fan in here also. So anyway, I mentioned this I think this is just way cool back here. So it's got its own door too, so the kids have their own little really their own room here. You could use this for just a maybe a separate room. Maybe you don't have kids, but you just want the idea of having maybe a little area where you can come back and just have some quiet time. Maybe you want to come back here and sew. So you got this bed that flips up out of the way. This is a scissor bed, so this pulls out and makes into a bed also. So you got 1, 2, 3, 4 beds back here that you could utilize. More drawers, more storage. It's already wired and everything for another TV, so you could put another TV there. You got another closet in here. Great place the kids could have all their games and whatever. Even has, basically you got three windows back here. You got a couple of egress windows, a little vent right there too where you can let some fresh air in. Pretty much all these windows open up too, so that you can get some fresh air in if you want. Makes it kind of nice. And the I mentioned it's all ducted. Your heat and your air conditioning is ducted, so this is all going to have heat and air conditioning. Even though you have a separation of space, it's still comfortable throughout the trailer. So it, you know, again, maybe you're looking for something a little bit larger that's accommodating. This is a great layout. It's called a 32RD, made by Keystone. It's Keystone Cougar. So feel free to give me a call if you have other questions or maybe want to see what you can do about getting into this one. You can reach me at 541-510-1017. Just ask for Jim. Thanks.